Part two. Part two, folks. Part two. Anyway, back to the story. We had a Wall Street Journal and others reported that Joe Biden had a plan and his administration had a plan to offer $450,000 per person. That would mean that a parent and child separated from the border by the Trump administration would be able to eligible to for a combined payment of $900,000, almost $1 million. The talks are part of negotiations between the Justice Department and lawyers representing the separated families in a number of tort cases that have claimed families experienced harm when they were forcibly separated. The sum of the payments remains unknown as negotiations continue, the sources said, but if enough parents and children are located, one source said, the U.S. government could be paying out hundreds of millions of dollars to compensate these families for what they went through. Under Trump's zero tolerance policy in 2018, a pilot program in 2017, more than 5,000 children were separated from their parents simply because their parents crossed the border illegally with them. Until the policy, crossing the border illegally, a misdemeanor under U.S. law, did not result in parents who crossed with children being federally prosecuted and therefore separated from their children. The Trump administration did not have a system in place to quickly reunite the families it separated. Today, more than 1,000 families are still estimated to be separated from each other, according to the White House. In many cases, the parents were deported back to their home countries while their children remained in the United States. And according to court records, more than 300 parents of children have still not been located. These families, particularly the young children, were deliberately traumatized by our government and deserve adequate compensation, but the chance to remain here so they can begin to heal, said Lee Jarrett, an attorney for the ACLU, which is representing separated families in a federal lawsuit. The Biden administration established a task force to track down and work to reunify separated migrant families. So far, the force has reunited just over 50 families. Lawyers representing those families hope more may soon be reunited after the Biden administration agrees to allow deported parents to return to the United States on a permanent or temporary parole basis. The payment under negotiation would go to the parents and the children, whether they are in the U.S. or Central America. Wow. Some lawyers worry that the large influx of cash may make them targets for gangs in the Central American countries. You know, so, you know, like I said, you know, he had that plan, you know, that was 2019, you know, so Biden era, you know, Biden's plan was to reverse the Trump era public charge rule that denied green cards to poor immigrants. And in 2019, the Trump administration announced a new hardline public charge rule for immigrants, and the rule denied legal status to all immigrants who use or might use social welfare programs such as food stamps. The Biden administration is proposing to revise the rule to its pre-Trump era form. The Biden administration is throwing out the Trump administration's public charge rule, which denied permanent residency to immigrants who use public assistance programs or were suspected of using them in the future. The Department of Homeland Security on Thursday said in a statement, the 2019 rule was not consistent with our nation's values. The news comes nearly a year after the administration said it would no longer defend the Trump era rule in court, where plaintiffs had argued that it federally discriminated against low-income immigrants. In November 2020, a federal judge agreed, though a coalition of conservative state attorney generals had challenged the Biden administration in court to potentially push the case to the Supreme Court. Previous administrations have denied permanent residency to immigrants who are deemed a potential financial burden. For example, more than half of their income is provided by the government. But the Trump administration took that a step further, seeking to deny legal status to anyone likely to use any public assistance program, from food stamps to Medicaid, for more than 12 months over a three-year period, or if it used two such programs at the same time in a single month. The Trump-era rule was seen as the brainchild, former senior advisor for the White House, Stephen Miller, who pushed to fast-track the regulation. Miller, an immigration hardliner, frequently cited white nationalist websites to justify anti-immigration policies, according to leaked emails published by the Southern Poverty Law Center. The new rule, the exclusion of immigrants based on fear that they would be dependent on government assistance, dates back to 1882, the same year Congress passed the Chinese Exclusion Act, providing federal authorities further legal justification for denying residency to non-European immigrants. The modern conception of the public charge dates back to the Clinton administration, which defined it as someone likely to become primarily dependent on cash assistance or long-term institutional care provided by the government. The proposed rule unveiled by the Biden administration would revert back to the Trump, pre-Trump definition of public charge, and individuals will not be penalized for choosing to access the health benefits and other supplemental services available to them in accordance with federal law. The new rule would not take effect immediately, but with public comments to be accepted for the next 60 days and a final regulation likely unveiled months later. But even so, and despite the fact that the previous rule is no longer in force, word of the proposed rule alone might well have an effect on immigrants' willingness to use social programs for which they are eligible. Wow. Man, they're bending over backwards here to do this, some of these things they do. So fast forward, this just came up. This is a new part that just came up, and it said Biden halts the plan to pay illegal immigrant families separated at the border. So yeah, the federal government has pulled out of negotiations to pay massive settlements to illegal immigrants separated at the border during the Trump administration. Attorneys of the family said Thursday. The American Civil Liberties Union, which had been leading negotiations for reported $450,000 payments, said the talks have ended, though it didn't know why. It's hard to understand the DOJ's decision, other than it was influenced by political considerations. The Justice Department confirmed the breakdown. While the parties have been unable to reach a global settlement agreement at this time, we remain committed to engaging with the plaintiffs and bring the justice to the victims of this abhorrent policy. Immigrants' rights activists call the move a political cowardice. After months of negotiations, the Biden's administration today abandoned thousands of families torn apart by the prior administration. Today, the payments had become a political loser for the Biden team, with polls showing the public decidedly opposed the idea. Faced with opposition, the ACLU launched an ad campaign in the Washington area this week to try to amp up pressure on Biden to repair the damage to the families. We are now putting the Biden administration on notice. This is the ACLU. Now, you know, the ACLU, they haven't done not one thing, not lifted not one finger to try to get reparations for black people in this country. However, it seems as though they're breaking their backs to get this money for these families that were separated by Trump at the border. Well, every time we start talking about reparations, the talks go nowhere. They just disappear. They disappear, and they push it under the rug. They tear it up. They shred it. They do like Trump did with his paperwork. They just shred it. They shred it and they throw it in the garbage can. They use the shredder. They use whatever they can to get rid of it. So what are we supposed to do? What we're supposed to do right now, I guess, is apply to become immigrants. Apply to become immigrants so we can get some of this money, because we've been separated from our families. So therefore, that should make us entitled to some of this $450,000 payments for each one of our family members as black people in this country. So that could be another thing. I mean, also, you under the Reconstruction Act, you stole all our land, from us that we had. You didn't educate the people on how they could get the land through the Homestead Act. And everybody that came here from other countries, from Europe, was able to go to the government and get that land that was earmarked for black people in this country after the Civil War by Abraham Lincoln. That was signed 1862 to 1865. By 1871, under the Reconstruction Act, they just got 86, everything that they were supposed to give you. To hell with 40 acres and a mule. They was talking about 160 acres. They were talking about that 40 acres and a mule crap is like you talking about 1/4 of what you were supposed to get. 1/4 of the land you were supposed to get. 160 acres under the Homestead Act. 40 acres and a mule. I don't even know where that garbage even came from. So, yeah, we got a lot of work to do here, folks, in order to get the stuff that we deserve, the stuff that we built. We helped design and build this country. We built this country on the backs of black people. Right to this day, you have people that are incarcerated in the penitentiaries that are working for free. Federal penitentiaries and state penitentiaries are working for free, or either 12, 13, 14 cents an hour right here in this country, right here. So that's slavery all over again under the 13th Amendment. You can be put back into slavery if you committed a crime and you went to the penitentiary. Your rights could be taken away from you and you could be put back into servitude. And that is what you young people really need to understand, is that you are earmarked for prison so they can put you back into slavery again. At the same time, they can deny you a decent education. They can deny you work. And we try to tell our sisters every day about how hard it is to find a job. They'll give you a job, but when it comes to black men, black men will not get hired. They'll hire everybody else. So no black man wakes up in the morning saying, I just love being poor. I just love being poor. I don't want no money. Sure, man, black men want to provide for their families. Sure they do. And we were doing that successfully all the way up until the mid-70s, when they started pumping all the drugs into the black community and destroying the black community from the inside out. They stopped hiring on one hand, pumped the drugs into the black community on the other hand. In the process of doing that, they created a false sense of security as far as financial security was concerned. So then the guns started appearing. The murders started happening. You got two people fighting over one little corner over here, shooting at each other like cowboys and Indians. Foolishness. For what? While you fighting about this over here, all the money that you're making is going on the other side of town. Those guys that are bringing that drug to this country do not look like you. They don't look like you at all, but they benefit from it. Look who has the stores in your neighborhood. Everybody owns a store of every nationality, from Asians, Europeans, south of the border. They all have stores in your neighborhood. You no longer own anything. You got maybe a barbershop here, a little beauty shop over there. But we used to have it all. Before the Civil Rights Act was signed, we owned our own communities. We owned our own stores. We had teachers that were teaching in our own schools. being segregated really wasn't bad. Once you look at it on from a financial standpoint, we had our own. We were making, taking care of our own communities. They wasn't doing it, that's for sure. So we were the ones that were taking care of our communities. So we deserve the right to be able to do that again. So the only way we're going to do it is to get together, stick together, and stop working against each other and try to get this paper, man. Let's get this paper and, you know, hey, let's go apply for this $450,000. You're giving it to them. We deserve it too. Give it to us too. You know, give it to us too, doggone it. Why you want to just give everything to everybody else that comes here, but the people that are already here that helped build the country, you don't want to give us nothing. Absolutely nothing except a jail sentence. Jail sentence and abuse. Wake up, people. Wake up. It's time to stick together here.
KP Video News, y'all.
KP Video News, y'all.